today.
Okay.
And stay tuned now for Ike Engelbaum, because he's coming up next. And he is wonderful at what he does, and it's always interesting. And you have a wonderful day. Don't go out unless you have to, because it really is not going to be very much fun out there. And you've been fun this morning, North. Thank you very much. I'm Bob Allison. Rob and I will see you tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock.
This is WNZK, Dearborn Heights, Detroit. Your ethnic superstation at 690 days, 680 nights. WNZK has available a few good hours of airtime for a few good programs to serve their communities. Radio is better than ever in targeting an audience that listens to what you say. Learn more about this exciting radio broadcasting opportunity by calling WNZK Radio at 248-557-3500.
Welcome to the Bright Side of Aging. My name is Ike Engelbaum. I'm a pharmacist and the publisher of AmericanSeniorGazette.org. It has been wisely said, you cannot help getting older, but you can help getting old. It has also been said that age is a matter of the mind. If you don't mind, it doesn't matter. My purpose in doing the show is so that seniors and caregivers can share their ideas and questions on how we can age gracefully and in a vertical position for as long as our good genes will allow. And if we've inherited bad genes, how to outwit them. Our topics include senior housing, financial, legal, safety, travel, health issues, interesting senior events in the community, and most of all, tips on how to put old on hold. When it's time to move, don't trust all your memories and most prized possessions to just some guys with a truck. Get personalized first-class treatment from bonded and experienced moving professionals. If you're confused about all the details involved in moving from one household to another, call 1-888-489-8980. Is always the concern of who should I call about the utilities? How shall I handle my household appliances? What should I do about my pets? What do I need to handle in advance of the move? For a free brochure titled Practical Hints to Make Moving Day Easier, call Aberdeen Van Lines at 1-888-489-8980. We can even help you in selling your home or any furniture that you may no longer wish for your next move. Let Aberdeen help make your move a dream. So call 1-888-489-8980 now. I'm pleased to announce that I've teamed up with Leeway Foundation, which is a non-profit organization devoted to helping the whole system of growing churches through health education, as well as prayer, as well as helping dozens of physical, spiritual needs for members that cannot attend the church. I like to title it A Church Without Walls. For a nominal fee per month, we now can help you reach out to your members by way of the app. We've customized this mobile app for small churches to form a partnership with a project named God's Warehouses. Now is the time to act if you want your church to grow in membership and increase church revenue. Please call 1-888-489-8980. Again, if you would like to have your church become larger and more self-sufficient, call 888-489-8980 for details. And we're on, as they say in the big time. And hopefully you're on. My goodness, the weather has certainly changed from yesterday. You know, they joke about the Caribbean changing every 10 minutes. I think we should start a new contest as to which part of the world has the quickest weather changes. But the good news is every day that ticks by, we're one day closer to spring. Whoa! And it's always good to look forward for spring. In fact, you know, I think since we're talking bright side of aging, is that one of the tips I try to promote is, as the initial announcement was, that age is a matter of the mind. If you don't mind, it doesn't matter. Rather than thinking back as to what used to be, why not enjoy what you have right now and look forward to what is about to be? I really am so frustrated when I hear people tell me, oh, things were so much better way back when, and then they miss out on the present. And the mission that I have with the show, as the title states, Bright Side of Aging, is that there is a bright side of aging. The fact that you are able at this point to hopefully be in relatively good health and still enjoy what is going on. We are living in such an exciting time. And like everything in life, there's good and bad. Do you realize, and I don't suggest you stay in your pajamas all day, but part of the day, if you get to know the basics of the internet and all, you can be in touch with anybody in the whole wide world without leaving your home. The sad part is that you got some pretty bad people out there that use that to promote what is not good. But I look at it from the bright side of aging. The bright side of aging is that you can actually see relatives and friends all around the world. And they can appreciate you and not from your appearance, because if that's something you're worried about, I do not have good news for you. You ain't going to get prettier. And you're going to get some wrinkles. But I feel that as long as you're able to get around and enjoy the friendships you've created, thrive in that, because that's the key to life. Why do some people, of course, genes have a lot to do with it as well. But the good news, again, is that the whole aspect of genes, believe it or not, even if you've inherited bad genes, it's only 70% that it really, the 70% you could actually change. 30%, unfortunately, you have to deal with. But think about it. If you have 70% going for you, you should be able to at least keep that 30% away. And there are various health habits and wonderful things that are out there today that you can actually extend your life, or at least make it more enjoyable. And that's why I am so pleased that I have the friendship of a Dr. Andre Lee. He is a PhD. How about that? A PhD for Dr. Andre Lee. He used to be the administrator of Highland Park General Hospital. And he, unfortunately, it closed up. So Dr. Lee is a typical example of someone who looks at the bright side of aging. And he said to himself, self, hey, I have this knowledge. How do I utilize my knowledge and help other people live a healthy life? And he has a nonprofit organization, Leeway Foundation, that's based on promoting good health habits. And I and actually am impressed with all of his other achievements. And whenever we can get him on the air, I try to. And he has a lot of activities going on. He's probably busier now today than he was when he was administrator of the hospital. And because he's a very intelligent guy, he said to himself again, self, why do I have to deal with Michigan weather when I can move to Tennessee? And I think that's why he, or one of the reasons, is that right, Dr. Lee? Is that why you moved to Tennessee?
Yes, sir. When I saw all those cold days, all that snow you guys were getting, I said, oh, geez, did you ever make the right decision?
And you remind me of our call the other day, and you say, well, hey, Ike, how is the weather up there? Thanks a lot.
I really felt bad. I had a lot of friends up there in Detroit, Michigan, and I laughed. And at the time you were getting that cold, I happened to be in Las Vegas at the time, which was even better.
Well, it was even better, right. And I'll tell you, I enjoy hearing a lot of your achievements, and for the folks that are not aware that you are actually devoted to promoting good health habits and also education and helping young black people, potential healthcare providers. So give us a little overview of what your activities are these days.
Well, we are working on developing an ongoing digital newsletter, a newspaper, if you will, that will have content that is useful to consumers, covering a variety of subjects. As you can see, healthcare is in the news every day for something, from opioids to trauma and to bills are too high. And so I'm thinking of coming up with some means of keeping the consumer informed. And I'm going to launch a series of webinars for the community, free, that people, if they want, they can sign up if they got an hour and look at it. Of course, you have to do it by internet. But so that's really high on my agenda in the next few weeks, really.
Right. Well, that's exciting, and I am going to do my best so that we can get the message out in Michigan. And I know every once in a while you come in, so we'd be delighted to try to get the message out, not only for the community, but also in church settings. And I just wondered if you could actually give us a little description of some of the projects. I know we've talked about the portraits for church for fundraising. Do you want to get into that for a few minutes?
Yeah, well, the mobile app is the one that's been the hottest item that I've had. Mm-hmm. And with that mobile app, a church can let their congregation know, get scripture lessons out. They can link to their website. They can help people see if they videotape their pastor's sermon. They can see that, and also they can put, there's a tab for event announcements. So when their church is having any kind of event, the ladies' club is meeting, or there's a Bible study going on, you can put the event announcements out. And the biggest part of that is that you can do online giving, which is the new technology. I know a lot of churches say, well, my folks don't really don't really want to use it, but you know what happened? We tried it when we tested it with my church. We did online giving just by itself, and you're right, there was a little bit of reluctance to do it. But when we switched over to the mobile app, everything tripled overnight. People love the mobile app, and the amount of tithing by the congregation has gone up because it's just so easy. When you're not there, you're sick or you're on vacation or you're just simply out of town or don't feel like going that week, you can still send in your money to the church. So the church has benefited tremendously from that cash flow. They don't get that disruption or missed donations. So that's one big item that has come up. The other is, of course, is still have the historical panels. available for people that want to put on something, say, for Black History Month, which is what we're in right now. I have a series of panels that are available. I've got a panel on display in Pittsburgh at McGee Women's Hospital that's started this week. I have one in Louisville, Kentucky, with Kindred Healthcare. They have a panel, and that one's one's devoted to Pennsylvania, and one's devoted to Kentucky. And then I have another one going up at the University of Pennsylvania Medical School panel going up. So, and churches can get that and use it as a fundraiser. So all they have to do is call me.
Yes,
and,
right.
And then my third thing is I'm writing grants. I just finished three grants this week, and so I'm having somebody proof it for me right now. To go out and help raise money for the churches through grants. So if a church wants some grant writers to help, contact me. We'll work it out.
Right. Well, I always give out my toll-free number, which is 888-489-8980. So if your church is looking for innovative ways and simple ways without having to run to the kitchen and make spaghetti and pancakes, this is something that actually is a lot more meaningful, because let's face it, you can make pancakes at home or go to a restaurant, but especially for young people, when you have this portrait program, which I was privileged to see when you had it on display in in fact, it was at Cobo Hall, as I recall. But And then there's local churches that are always looking ways to reach out to young people. So you send the portraits out, they set up the portraits, and there's a nominal fee to get them out there. And then you ask for donations for people to study the history of some of the more prominent Black figures in the whole area of not only the healthcare field, but you still send out that email newsletter.
It goes out every Monday.
Every Monday,
right? We're doing it for about 2-3 years now, and
right.
Well received.
If someone wants to contact you, since we've been talking about technology, do you welcome email notifications, or how? Go ahead.
They can send me a notice to Leeway, LEWAY 333 at AOL.
Is that two E's in there, or just one E?
No, just one E.
LEWAY Foundation.
333.
Okay, well, actually, that should be easy, since I don't want to confuse the issue, but the area code in the Detroit area is 313, so you got Leeway 333. That's wonderful, and of course, our toll-free number, 888-489-8980. And if any church or member of a church wants to set this up, it's very easy to do, and that's the exciting thing about technology. Can even Skype your message at appropriate times to churches. And the wonderful thing that we have today that we did not have before is that you can reach almost every church in any community. So there, in my opinion, when you think about it, we're always looking to how do we get young people to participate in the church. If they find out in a positive way that, hey, this is where I came from, and are learning about positive-minded people and see what they've been able to accomplish, they can be motivated to actually be more responsible citizens. As I've told you, I'm quite active in an organization called Unify Detroit, where we go out to Black churches. There's about 20 that we have now, and we do a monthly health fair. So if you know, you're on the board or involved in a church setting and are looking for ways to reach out not only to your members, but to other people, just to get to know one another. Leeway Foundation, as I like to coin it, is you're leading the way. Is that right?
I hope so. We're trying.
God bless, and I look forward to our next conversation. And keep on. Right now, we got to take a brief break, and we will be right back. Don't you dare go away.
All right.
If you need a helping hand to stay at home, or maybe you'd like somebody to provide transportation or grocery shopping or run errands for you, or maybe you're going to need help with bathing or personal grooming, or you need home renovations to enable you to stay in that home safely and securely. Or maybe you can't leave your home, but you need somebody to come in and do things like a doctor, a nurse, a podiatrist, a dentist, or to have your prescriptions delivered to you. Well, House Calls on Wheels is the answer to all of that. House Calls on Wheels provides both medical and non-medical services in your home. And all the medical services are covered by insurance. The non-medical services start as low as $10 an hour. So if you or someone you know needs a helping hand at home, call House Calls on Wheels for a free in-home consultation. And that toll-free number is 1-888-489-8980. All right? That's 1-889-8980.
I'm pleased to announce that I've teamed up with Leeway Foundation, which is a non-profit organization devoted to helping the whole system of growing churches through health education, as well as prayer, as well as helping dozens of physical, spiritual needs for members that cannot attend the church. I like to title it A Church Without Walls. For a nominal fee per month, we now can help you reach out to your members by way of the app. We've customized this mobile app for small churches to form a partnership with a project named God's Warehouses. Now is the time to act if you want your church to grow in membership and increase church revenue. Please call 1-888-489-8980. Again, if you would like to have your church become larger and more self-sufficient, call 888-489-8980 for details. And welcome back. And since it's titled, the show is Bright Side of Aging, I want to stay on theme. And one of the bright sides of aging is that you should not think back about the miserable times you've had in life, but enjoyable times. And sometimes it takes more than just sitting there in the rocking chair. And if you are interested in hearing old-time music, I hate to say old-time music, but music that you heard when you were less chronologically blessed, I can't think of any better station to listen to than our sister station, WCXI, 1160 AM. And one of the spark plugs of the show is a real showbiz-sounding name. And he is Mr. Showbiz almost, Jimmy James. Hello, Jimmy James.
Hello, Ike, and thanks for the invitation today.
And since you're right across the hall from our studio, you're always invited to walk across the hall, okay?
Well, I appreciate that. Thank you again.
And you're on 1160 a.m. every day.
Yes, I'm pretty much steady starting at 9 o'clock and going through lunchtime into the afternoon Monday through Friday. So a little more normal schedule, but we still get a little crazy and have a little fun as well.
Yeah, well, I've had the joy of sitting alongside you over the years. I think we've known each other probably for a quarter of a century or so.
Back at WPON, the old station. And every once in a while, John or Michael or one of the guys will call in to see how things are going. And they ask about you, Ike, how things are going for you.
Yeah, right. Well, that's nice. It's nice to know that there are people actually still interested. And what I'm not saying this because you ain't paying me. In fact, you could if you wanted to. But
you know where I work.
So the point is that I've got a lot of friends like me who really enjoy those oldie-type songs. And you have the gift of picking stuff that people that are over 50, let's say,
or baby boomers.
Baby, they don't really appreciate, the hard rock stuff. There's nothing wrong with it, but if you grew up with certain type of music, you have the gift to pick the best of the best. So congratulations. But when you're not on the air, you got gigs, as they call it, right?
Yeah, in fact, Ike, if he can still move and groove, we got a little sock hop going on this Saturday night in Redford.
Yeah, right.
And we'll have a great oldies band. They're known as the Del Rays. They do the doo-wop, the dance music, the girl groups, so a good variety mix of 50s and 60s dancing music. That'll be at the AOH Hall on 5 Mile Road in Beach Daily in Redford. Tickets are $20, and you can order by calling KC, one of the Del Rays. His number is 313-231-2413. That's 313-231-2413. And don't forget, it's Valentine's next week. So remember that little lady in your life, but be sure to check out our Valentine's dance. And that's going on next Saturday night, February the 16th. I know Valentine's is the 14th, but we're going to party on the 16th, the weekend, have a little more fun. And we've got some great entertainment going on that night with Mondo Cane, Del Rays again, and I'll be spinning your favorite oldies. That's $30. You get a full dinner, chicken, meatballs, potatoes, vegetable, dessert, all that good stuff. Beer is included for the price as well. And that'll be at the Lascala VFW Hall on Waverly Road. That's in Dearborn Heights, east of Telegraph, and just south of Warren. And again, tickets available, 734-642-5599 or 734-260-4368. And, of course, you can always call us at the station. We'll make arrangements to get you tickets.
Yeah,
so one this weekend and next weekend.
Right.
So keep pretty busy. I've got more coming up, but
I won't
overshadow you today. If you invite me back, we'll talk about some other things coming up in March.
Yeah, all right. Well, and I always like to give out my toll-free number because folks hear it enough times that they can write it down, and that's 888-489-8980. But if you belong to an organization, and I belong to quite a few of them, like the Rotary Club or the Optimist Club, and they're always looking for ways to have the members enjoy each other's company. If you belong to a church group, why not get a few people together, and especially if you're over 50 and you want to get to that feel of music that you loved when you were young. I mean, get the same feeling almost of when I was younger, when I hear some of the greats that you have, and of course you play the King, right? Elvis?
We also play class reunions, Ike, as well. We've done many of those over the years, so if you have something coming up for your high school reunion, college, whatever it may be, we do that as well.
Right. Well, and you certainly have the library to make it happen. All right. Listen.
Thank you,
Jimmy, Ike. Jimmy, we'll talk again hopefully next week.
Sounds great.
Right now, I never like to leave this segment without my favorite parting thought, which is, yesterday is history. Tomorrow is a mystery. Today is a gift. And that's why we call it the present. Please enjoy your present by looking and living life with a bright side of aging. ¶¶ Welcome to the Entrepreneurs Network Radio Show. Our mission is to interview successful entrepreneurs who are willing to share with us their ideas and experiences, both the successes and the failures. Because as it has been jokingly said, you should learn from the mistakes of others because you'll never live long enough to make them all yourself. My name is Ike Engelbaum, and I'm the founder of the Entrepreneurs Network of Michigan, which is a group of motivated people that are all interested in helping each other and achieving our personal and professional goals. Please check out our website, entrepreneursnetworkofmichigan.com, for meeting schedule as well as self-improvement material. Our philosophy is that if it's to be, it's up to me. When it's time to move, don't trust all your memories and most prized possessions to just some guys with a truck. Get personalized first-class treatment from bonded and experienced moving professionals. If you're confused about all the details involved in moving from one household to another, call 1-888-489-8980. Is always the concern of who should I call about the utilities? How shall I handle my household appliances? What should I do about my pets? What do I need to handle in advance of the move? For a free brochure titled Practical Hints to Make Moving Day Easier, call Aberdeen Van Lines at 1-888-489-8980. We can even help you in selling your home or any furniture that you may no longer wish for your next move. Let Aberdeen help make your move a dream. So call 1-888-489-8980 now.
If you need a helping hand to stay at home, or maybe you'd like somebody to provide transportation or grocery shopping or run errands for you, or maybe you're going to need help with bathing or personal grooming, or you need home renovations to enable you to stay in that home safely and securely. Or maybe you can't leave your home, but you need somebody to come in and do things like a doctor, a nurse, a podiatrist, a dentist, or to have your prescriptions delivered to you. Well, House Calls on Wheels is the answer to all of that. House Calls on Wheels provides both medical and non-medical services in your home. And all the medical services are covered by insurance. The non-medical services start as low as $10 an hour. So if you or someone you know needs a helping hand at home, call House Calls on Wheels for a free in-home consultation. And that toll-free number is 1-888-489-8980. All right? That's 1-888-489-8980.
And welcome, and hope to welcome you tomorrow morning and every Thursday morning over at the Level One Bank, 37100 Woodward in Bloomfield Hills. If you're an entrepreneur or actually wanting to be an entrepreneur and you don't know quite how to go about it, join us. It's free to attend, 9:15 to 10:30. We serve you coffee and snacks, so that way you can have an enjoyable experience both internally as well as mentally. As I like to joke about it, you walk out smarter than you walked in. And we've been doing this now for close to 50 years, almost half a century. I pride myself that I'm probably one of the original guys that started the whole concept of the networking meetings that you have around town. Now, of course, with technology, there's so many ways that you can meet and greet with people, but nothing beats, in my opinion, human being to human being connection. So join us on Thursdays, 9:15 to 10:30, the first Saturday of each month. We actually get together at noon, and we just had a meeting this past Saturday, and we had nice attendance. I usually try to limit it around 20 people. And the reason say, I like to go to groups where there's like 500 or so people. I got news for you. Those type of groups, and I admit that I go to quite a few of those as well. But how many people can you really speak to in an hour and get to know each other? Usually it's around 10, 15, maybe 20 people. So this is what makes our group unique. We help you achieve your goals. And if you need advice on how to get motivated and all, or marketing strategies, or financial help, and you can't make the meetings, give me a call at our toll-free number, and I can put you in touch with one of our members who's into coaching and has had experience. And that number, of course, is 888-489-8980. And no matter how well talented and talented you may be, there's always a need for a coach. Do you know of any sports team that doesn't have coaches? In fact, many times when the team isn't doing that well, guess who gets sacked first? The coach. So if you want to subscribe to the great philosopher Yogi Berra, he had a philosophy, or he had great sayings. One of them that I like is that if you look at something long enough, you actually begin to see something. All right? So what do you see when you see successful teams like the Patriots and all? And I am not a sports fan to the nth degree, but if it weren't for the coach, they couldn't have put that kind of a team together. But what about in your life? How can you benefit from coaching? Well, you find out about a motivational speaker and coach by the name of Joseph Drolshagen. For over 23 years, Joseph has worked with individuals, helping them build their dreams, accelerate their results, and create richer, more fulfilling lives in areas of health and well-being, relationships, vocation, and time, and guess what? Money, freedom, right? As I like to say, you don't have to be rich and famous to be happy. You just have to be rich. Well, Joseph, delighted to tell you, is going to be in town, and he's going to be in Royal Oak at the Unity of Royal Oak, which is located on Crooks Road, 2500 Crooks Road in Royal Oak. And because he's a giving guy, he doesn't charge up front, but donations, as we like to call them, love offering, is certainly appreciated. If you are available 10 a.m. to 12 noon, you can hear Joseph, and he, I am sure, is going to cover highlights of his book, Life Lessons. Hello, Joseph Drolshagen.
Hello, what an honor to be here with you this morning. And you just cracked me up.
That's what my wife tells me. We just celebrated our 57th year anniversary.
So I've been cracking.
So I've had a lot of experience in cracking. And not the bad stuff. I'm a pharmacist, so I got to stay away from that stuff. I am delighted, and the material I get, Luther Taylor is to be commended. He's a wonderful guy.
Oh, he is.
And he started this Jobs Club, and you are going to be a speaker this Saturday, and you're going to make a presentation titled Embrace Your Passion. So give us a little teaser, as they say in the business, of what is some of the information you're going to cover.
Oh, absolutely, Ike. And like I said, it's just an honor to get to be here with you this morning and such. And so I'm a native Detroit boy. I was born, raised in Michigan, spent a majority of my life there. And so my whole passion, so this whole thing lit up for me when I was 22 years old. I sat in the Unity Church of it was actually Church of Today, led by Jack Bolin. And I sat in the audience. I had no idea who he was. But listening to that just lit this passion within me to motivate and inspire people to live life more like they wanted to. And so I left there at 22 and became a student of that work. And I've consistently and continually, and still do, continue to learn about this. And what I've been able to do is, you know, being born in that area, I grew up being taught that a man gets a job, supports a family, and then near the end of his life, if his household's out, that he gets to retire for a while. But that was never my passion. My passion was to do what I love to do, which is help people live a better life. And so in the process of this stuff, I built a career up to a vice president of sales for a $60 million corporation. And I did all those steps up the corporate ladder, my bachelor's degree and everything. And at some point, I just couldn't take it anymore because that passion was inside. That desire of knowing what my purpose is was inside. But I kept pushing that down in order to honor what I was told a man is or how a man, you know, how a man lives his life. And at some point, through events that I talk about at the workshop to help other people open that up, at some point, all of that started changing. The avenue started showing up. And what I've learned is opportunities for each and every one of us show up constantly in our life. But if we're not zoned into that, if we're living our life based on default of what's going on in our situations, circumstances, and conditions, then we get stuck in that rut of that, and we don't even see these other things going on. So what I do at the workshops is it's very interactive. We get to do some different things with like a time machine exercise and such, which really helps people tap into that vision within them and start bringing it outwardly. And all of a sudden, when we can open that up, even just a little crack, we can start seeing these opportunities that are showing up for us all the time, and we can start grabbing hold of those, and then we can start experiencing life differently. So one of the things that one of my favorite authors is Michael Singer. In the book, Tethered Soul, he says that the intention of our mind was to help us solve complex problems. That makes sense, right?
Yep.
But most people let their mind, their thoughts, dictate their life. And so they run their life based on their thoughts. And so what happens is I help people understand and see that connection between our thinking creates our reality. Mm-hmm. And when we understand that, we can look at our situations, circumstances, or the conditions that we're in at any time and drive that back to know what our thoughts are, where our thinking is at, and where it's coming from. And by adjusting that, I have helped people from 22-year-old kids, a lot of people in mid-late careers, up to an 83-year-old woman who came up to me after one of my workshops, and she said, "Joseph, before I met you, I thought I was too old to dream." And that's how she was living her life. We ended up working together, and in the time we worked together, she had gone to three of her bucket list items that she traveled to and already had travel plans set up and secured for two more. I work with a lot of people in their mid-careers, late careers, who are just doing kind of the did, or at one time they were passionate about it, and over duration of time they become where it's stale and they just can't stand it. I've had two teachers I've worked with, school teachers, and one of them, when she came to me, she said, "I cannot stand doing this for even another week. I'm just so tired with the politics. I get so little interaction time with the actual kids and teaching like I used to," and she was just so fed up. And we started working together and building that vision, and what she found out is her passion was still in teaching. And through the process of going through my program with her, taking her through my program, is she ended up evolving, and situations, circumstances around her changed with the powers that be. And by the time we were done, she was like, "Man, I got back again, and I'm doing what I love doing and still teaching." I had another teacher who came to me, similar situation. She has since decided that her passion is in having her own business. She up and moved her house and lives in the area where she's always wanted to live. She started a hair salon slash boutique, and now she's starting to add mobile buses, that is custom buses she's making, where she can go to businesses and cut hair and such. And just opening up that vision. I had a 22-year-old kid, Ike, who had called me up and spoke about, he said, you know, I'm going to school. It should be the time of my life. But all I'm doing is sitting around, you know, smoking things I shouldn't be and playing Xbox. And I can't stand living like this. And then we ended up working together. And throughout that process, not only did he get off of that stuff in the Xbox, but he started his own business creating websites for small businesses. He got back into being social with hockey and that, and social clubs around him. And this kid, in such a short period of time, is loving his life right now. Go ahead.
I was just going to ask, if your phone rings from someone who wants to take advantage of your coaching skills, do you have any particular age bracket of the person and what profession they're in? Or is it universal to almost anyone that's unhappy with what they're doing?
Yeah, it's pretty much universal. You know, like I said, I've worked from 80, I've worked beyond that. There's so many people I meet that are retired. And so they're retired, and I love when I see somebody, how are you enjoying retirement? And they go, every day is like a Saturday. And I love hearing that. But so many people I talk to like that say, I did that for the year or the first 18 months, and now I'm just sitting around bored stiff. And when I start working with them, I help them reignite, what that is, that vision? What are those things that you had that you wanted to do, be, have, create, experience in your life? And we start moving into doing that. So the difference between what I do, I'd like to point this out if you don't mind, the difference between what I do and typical, like, you know, traditional therapy is that what I do, it focuses on the now forward. So it doesn't matter where somebody's come from. It doesn't matter what they've been through. None of that matters. It matters where is somebody right here at this moment, and where do you want to go? What's your dreams for your life?
Well, that sounds
right. Not mutually exclusive where it comes to shifting paradigms and patterns and those things that are, you know, that are deciding our limits right now.
I'm sorry. Well, that's great. Well, you've been doing this for a while, so you must know what you're doing.
I seem to have had
well, that's great.
Success.
Now, do you bring that out in your book, Life's Lessons? Is it personal experiences, or is it a recap of some of the people you've helped? Who would you say your book is most appropriate for?
My book is most appropriate for. So here's what at the back of my book I wrote inside of it. Yeah, it's from my personal journey into going from that transition from being a victim of life, from living by my circumstances, situations, and conditions, by living by my limited patterns that tell me you can only be or do this much in your life, and we all have those, to that opening of that and the events that happened that opened that doorway to when I started looking at things. So I had gone through a divorce and I was forced to take away from my 12-year-old son and it was just killing me. And through that process, when I stopped looking as being dumb, and through a series of events, it's explained in the book, through a series of events and things happening, as I got to a point and I said, okay, if I'm going to start taking, like, if I look at the things that are happening and I take the judgment out of them, so there's no good, bad, right, wrong, fair, unfair, just, unjust, and if I'm going to go about this believing that life happens for me and not to me, then I could ask a question, why is this happening in my life? And instead of seeing where I was a victim or picked on or held down or whatever it may be, I could start seeing where those events have helped me to look at things in order to change. When I'm in a victim mode, I wasn't able to see it. But I'll give you a for instance, is after my divorce, I was paying child support, spousal support, house payments, like all this stuff. I didn't even want the divorce. Like,
yeah, no one wants a divorce. In fact, the more I hear, unfortunately, we run out of time for this segment almost, and I have another guest that I wanted to give some time to. In my opinion, I like to keep it simple, and that is, you not only help people who are sort of floundering around, not knowing which direction to go, but in serious situations of getting a divorce, how do you recoup from that and make a life that's meaningful and satisfying? So this Saturday from 10 a.m. to 2 at Unity Royal Oak Church, it's non-denominational, so you're not going to be converted in any form of religion. It's just a great place to meet in Royal Oak. Anyone that's interested, and I look forward to meeting with you, and I'm sure that you'll have your book available as well. And just call our toll-free number, which is 888-489-8980. Have a great day, and I'll look forward to seeing you on Saturday. How's that?
The only other thing I'd like to add is to donate. I'll go to the facility.
Right. You're not making anything personally, and I respect that. And right now, unfortunately, I got to take a brief break. Fortunately, we have a great guest, Don Zavis, coming right on. Don't you dare go away, folks. We'll be right back. When it's time to move, don't trust all your memories and most prized possessions to just some guys with a truck. Get personalized first-class treatment from bonded and experienced moving professionals. If you're confused about all the details involved in moving from one household to another, call 1-888-489-8980. Is always the concern of who should I call about the utilities? How shall I handle my household appliances? What should I do about my pets? What do I need to handle in advance of the move? For a free brochure titled Practical Hints to Make Moving Day Easier, call Aberdeen Van Lines at 1-888-489-8980. We can even help you in selling your home or any furniture that you may no longer wish for your next move. Let Aberdeen help make your move a dream. So call 1-888-489-8980 now. And welcome back. And on the line is a super coach of sales and whatever entrepreneurial career you're considering or are in, there is one magic word that makes things happen, and that's sales. And one of the prime coaches and international speakers, I might add, is Don Zavis, who I'm proud to call a friend. He is unfortunately in a state right now that we would envy to be there, but he's there and we ain't, and that's in Arizona. You're in Tucson, Arizona, and I'm looking out at snow, and one weathercaster said, it's cloudy. We meant to say cloudy. Anyway, Don, hopefully it's sunny out there in Tucson. Is that right?
we had like a little sprinkle of rain, but now the sun's out, the skies are blue. It's going to be warm today, and there's plenty of room in Tucson for anyone who would like to visit us.
All right. Well, that's the wonderful thing about technology today. They can hear a lot of your wisdom and all being in this situation. And maybe down the line we can plan a trip out there as a team. And Don, I wanted to give you an opportunity to let folks know who you are and your credentials.
Absolutely.
So go ahead. Go for it.
Well, I'm a national sales trainer and sales coach. I also do keynote speaking throughout the world on revenue development topics, so I'm an expert in teaching people how to sell. Mm-hmm. And one of the things that I find frequently is that most people are brilliant at what they do. You know, they're brilliant CPAs, they're brilliant plastic surgeons, they're brilliant You know, they're brilliant at what they do. Unfortunately, nowadays, before people can be brilliant at what they do, in a lot of cases, they got to be brilliant at what I do, which is sales development. And I really think that's kind of the hallmark of my practice, and I think that's one of the reasons I've been successful. I've been doing this since 2005. Mm-hmm. Prior to 2005, I would buy and sell companies. So one of the areas that I always kind of excelled in was finding that X factor, finding that special magic that a company had or an individual had, and I would take that and certainly develop it. And fortunately, it has worked very, very well for me since that time. So got into coaching and training back in 2005 and never looked back. And interestingly enough, you and I believe, originally connected up about 2005, 2006.
Yes, right.
So you and I have been friends for 13 years.
Yes, right. Well, and being Jewish, that's bar mitzvah. That's great. Now, the wonderful thing about technology is that even though you're out of state, we can share our thoughts and all on a weekly basis. Is that correct?
Absolutely. In fact, that's one of the things I wanted to talk about because I know that you're so active with the Entrepreneurs Network, and I have such great respect for entrepreneurs, right? Mm-hmm. You know, the people that are actually doing it.
Mm-hmm.
That we do a session. Now, I actually have an office in Michigan. We have our office here in Tucson, and we're developing an office in California. Mm-hmm. But I do, the vast majority of my clients are not in the Tucson area. So mm-hmm. we do a live broadcast every Friday. It generates at 9 o'clock Tucson time, which at least now for the foreseeable future, would be 11 o'clock your time. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to make access to the live broadcast available to the Entrepreneurs Network, as well as the individuals that are listening to your radio program for at least a limited basis.
Mm-hmm.
We also have a Vimeo channel, so all the sessions that we do are actually recorded and put into our archive
mm-hmm.
and are then made available through some very simple password protection. Again, I wanted to make that available to the Entrepreneur Network group as well as the listeners of your radio program.
Mm-hmm. That's great. So 11 a.m. our time, mm-hmm. Michigan time, what do we do?
Right. Well, actually, to get started, all I would need to do is have those people contact me. Let me give you some phone numbers and such where I can be reached. So to reach me through our Michigan office would be area code 248-497-5869.
Okay.
And if you needed to reach us through our Southwest office, that's 520-903-4654.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can email me directly at Don Zavis. That's all one word, D-O-N, Z as in zebra, A as in apple, V as in victory, I as in igloo, S as in Sam, at comcast.net. And we'll make sure that they get all the login information. And we would love to have me as our guest. It's really my personal goal to have everybody become amazing salespeople, and as a result of that, have an amazing life.
Well, I've had the joy of, while you were here, of having you speak at numerous times of our meeting.
Yep.
And
yep.
even though I pride myself on having been in sales for most of my life, in fact, probably over 50 years.
Sure.
So the thing is I always learn something. And this is the key. When it's as simple as just logging on and you hear your thoughts,
yep.
no matter how many years you've been in sales, someone like you, Don Zavis, who mm-hmm. is constantly doing coaching and
yep.
lecturing, you have a different perspective and another way
yep.
of expressing it, and there's always new stuff. And the
Absolutely.
Worst thing, and the worst thing you can do as an entrepreneur is stop improving yourself. That's
Absolutely.
The life. You got to keep on going.
Yep.
Don, we'll keep on going. Unfortunately,
Thank
we've
you.
Run out of time. We'll talk to you again hopefully next week, and if not, the following week, because we do
yep.
want to keep the connection going, even though
Absolutely.
Your weather is so much better. Right now, folks.
I look forward to that as well.
Right now, I like to leave this segment with, if you really want to get anything done in life, you'll find a way. And if you don't, you'll find an excuse. And there is no excuse for not achieving your dreams and goals in America, because it is the greatest country in the whole world. Remember, a goal is just a dream with a deadline.
WNZK has available.